Same. What to study the next part of the element of group number 16, 17 and 18. At group number 16, we want to study here. Here, the group number 16 element, oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium and polonium. In that element, all the elements, they having shown the allotropes. They having shown the allotropes. Here, the first element, oxygen, they having the allotropes. Allotrope is one of the more commonly to be observed here. That oxygen, dioxygen, that ozone, that will be the two allotropes of oxygen. Sulfur, alpha sulfur and beta sulfur, alpha and beta. Second name of this rhombic sulfur and monoclinic sulfur. Then selenium, that red selenium, grey selenium, that will be non-metallic and it will be metallic. Then tellurium, that will be crystalline and amorphous form, the two allotropes. In polonium, alpha and again beta, that both are metallic here. Means here the group number 16, all the elements, that all elements, they have observed the allotropes. Then how to study here the difference between the alpha sulfur and beta sulfur. Alpha and beta sulfur. Then second name is the rhombic sulfur. Rhombic sulfur or monoclinic. Monoclinic sulfur. Second name of this alpha sulfur is the rhombic sulfur. Or beta sulfur is the monoclinic. Then differentiate between that alpha sulfur, that two allotropes of sulfur, or differentiate by the different property like color, shape, melting point, then solubility, then density. We have to observe the difference in between that. See, the first property we have to study in the rhombic sulfur, that will be rhombic sulfur and monoclinic sulfur. Or second name is alpha sulfur or beta sulfur. That rhombic sulfur, that color of rhombic sulfur, it will be the here yellow color. But that yellow color is the pale yellow color. Pale yellow color we have to observe here. In rhombic, in monoclinic system, that will be the bright yellow color, it will be observed. Difference between alpha and beta. In rhombic, it will be pale yellow color, then it will be bright. Then that shape of rhombic sulfur, it will be the orthorhombic shape. Here made a monoclinic crystalline needle shape. Monoclinic crystalline needle shape. And here it will be orthorhombic shape. Then melting point, it will be 385.8 Kelvin. It will be 393.0 Kelvin. Means that melting point, it will be also different. Then solubility here in rhombic sulfur, it will be insoluble in carbon disulfide, insoluble in carbon disulfide, it will be soluble. That beta sulfur, it will be soluble in here in carbon disulfide. Also the density, it will be 2.06 in centimeter cube. They have given the density here 1.93. That density, it will be given here in centimeter cube. This is the difference between the alpha sulfur and beta sulfur. The 2 mark questions for differentiation, it will be asked that we have to differentiate the alpha and beta sulfur, that rhombic sulfur and monoclinic sulfur. Second name of these is the rhombic sulfur and monoclinic sulfur. This differentiate point related to our color, shape, melting point, solubility, density, we have to differentiate here the point. Point that rhombic sulfur and in monoclinic sulfur. Then next part we have to study here the oxy acids of sulfur. See, oxy acids of sulfur we have to study here. Oxy acids of sulfur. And that first oxy acids of sulfur, it will be given H2SO3, that sulfurous acid. Then question asked for that, it will be given here the name, that sulfurous acid, or draw the structure, or in MCQ's question ask the formula. Means anyway they have asked the question. Means first we have to draw here the structure of sulfurous acid. At oxy acids of sulfur related to here, or to draw here the structure, that sulfur that oxides of sulfur means sulfur. First you have to write here. Then 2OH, because here 2 hydrogen, 2 OH, and here 1 oxygen, H2SO3, means that will be the sulfurous acid. And one lone pair they have given, that lone pair it will be right here, or double one you have to write here, then lone pair it will be dropped. Then second sulfurous acid, sulfuric acid H2SO4. In H2SO4 we have to add only one oxygen from that formula, sulfurous acid to sulfuric acid. Then we have to draw only the double bonded, that H2SO4 it will be dropped. The structure. Then second, third oxygen six of sulfur is the pyro, or it will be second pyrosulfuric acid, or pyrosulfurous sulfuric acid, or disulfuric acid. And their formula they have given, the H2S2O7, H2S2O7. And the pyro means one of the oxygen, it will be bonded to that sulfur. Pyro, pyro linkage, sulfur, oxygen, sulfur. That will be the pyro. And that formula H2S2O7. And the H2 means 2 oxygen, we have to write here in terms of OH bonding. Then how many oxygen? 1, 2, 3. OH, H2, that will be. And oxygen double bonded here, we have to write. And how many oxygen it will be completed? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then another one, double bonded, we have to write. 6 and 7. This we have to draw that structure of that pyrosulfuric acid. H2S2O7. Then another word for the structure of oxyacids of sulfur, that will be peroxy. Means we have to remember that peroxy means that peroxy, oxygen, oxygen, and then it will be joined to the sulfur. That linkage is oxygen, oxygen, peroxy. Upon peroxide, H2O2. We link us as the oxygen, oxygen, here hydrogen, and here atom. Peroxy, oxygen, oxygen linkage. That will be peroxy, sulfuric acid. We have to attach that and then to complete the structure, we have to remember that formula of peroxy, pyro, or from the word they have asked the question, draw the structure for 1 mark, 2 mark, that will be a question asked on oxyacids of sulfur. Then oxyacids of chlorine, oxyacids of chlorine, and that will be oxyacids of chlorine, we have to draw here the 4 chlorine oxyacids they have given in there. That will be first the hypochlorous acid, that formula it will be HOCl. Second, that hypochlorous acid, then chlorous acid, HOClO, you want the other way, HOCl2, sorry, HCLO2, it will be right in that way, HClO2. Then third, it will be HClO3, then HClO4. Means here, hypochlorous acid, second is the chlorous acid, third is the chloric acid, and fourth is the perchloric acid. Perchloric acid. And that will be draw here the structure part, that hydrogen, oxygen, chlorine. Then another one oxygen joining, it will be oxygen for here. HOClO, oxygen bond, and ClO2, double bond here, means hypochlorous, tanantar, chlorous, and chloric, and perchloric, means this will be the oxyacids of chlorine, oxyacids of chlorine, that hypochlorous, tanantar, chlorous, chloric, and perchloric acid. Hypochlorous, chlorous acid, chloric acid, and perchloric acid. We have to add that oxygen only and draw the structure. See, today we have to stop here.